Are you trying to determine what model to use for and when you should use it, like Grok Codefast, Anthropic Sonnet 4.5, and the new Haiku model that just dropped? If you're looking for answers, then this video is for you. Let's jump straight to it. All right, just a quick landscape of what we're looking at in this video. We're looking at Grok Codefast 1, which is the model made by xAI, that's Elon Musk. And then we've got Anthropic's two models, both Claude Sonnet 4.5 and Claude Haiku 4.5 that just got released the other day. And we just want to look at what are the advantages for each one and when you should actually consider using it in the real world. So just note some of this is based off research, but let's have a quick look at Grok Codefast just generally. This is what I'm calling the speed demon. So it's blazingly fast. You get anything between 190 to 271 tokens per second, and it's extremely affordable. You're paying 20 cents to $1.50 per million tokens. So it's very budget friendly, and you actually can try it for free for experimentation. And it actually has quite a large context window, up to 256 kilobytes context. That covers Grok Codefast. Just a very extremely fast and cheap model to use. All right, so what are the strengths and cons of Grok Codefast model? So Grok Code, like we said earlier, is very quick for prototyping, so you can build a prototype very quick. It's very budget friendly. It's 10 times cheaper than most premium models. But the issues is where I really want to focus a little bit on. I've found this personally, it's inconsistent with quality. So sometimes it works really well, but sometimes it degrades very badly. And sometimes it can get caught in like error loop problems that it can't solve. So it just keeps trying to solve it and it runs into the same issue. And it does have some issues with knowledge framework gaps, mainly on Tailwind CSS. So if you are trying to use Tailwind CSS, it does seem to struggle. And I've also seen this when I'm trying to build front ends with Grok Codefast using Tailwind. It's not really been great. And other people have also reported it can sometimes delete working code while making changes, sometimes removing functional logic and refactoring attempts. So it sometimes goes a bit haywire, so you need to control it. And we've seen this in, you know, other examples before. All right, this brings us to the next model. We're looking at Claude Sonnet 4.5. So this has been out for a bit of a while. I've been using this. I've been really impressed with it. The accuracy score has been really great. It actually follows instructions really well. So I don't actually seem to worry about the code quality. It follows instructions. And essentially, it went up for 82% on the SWE bench. And it's got a safety score of 98.7. This is just like the metrics that they were given out by Anthropic themselves. All right, but what are the good things about Sonnet 4.5 and what are some of the concerns? Well, it's really good at architectural. So you can actually use Sonnet 4.5 to actually discuss how you want to build and architect your system. And you can actually do that fairly well. It's actually got quite a good knowledge base. Cost factor, it's not too bad. It's $3 to $15. It's pretty much the same as Sonnet 4 that we had earlier. So there's not really much change, but it is a lot faster at responding. So I think it's two times faster than Sonnet 4. And it can also run for 30 hours on complex refactoring across large code bases. So you can actually run it for longer periods of time. And all right, and just looking at the strengths and concerns around Sonnet 4.5, in my experience, it's really great for architectural design. So you can actually use it to help design a lot of the architecture with you. It can actually run for 30 hours plus on complex refactoring. I haven't done this myself, but look forward to trying this in the future. The cons with Sonnet compared to these other models, it is more expensive. So it's $3 to $15 per million tokens. And some of the testing doesn't always reflect what it's like in the real world. So just take that in note. But I've been very impressed with Sonnet. I feel like I give it instructions. It seems to follow quite to the T if I'm keeping my context window, you know, half empty at least. All right, just looking at the new model that got released yesterday, Haiku 4.5. So this is actually, in terms of performance-wise, seems quite great. It's actually a third of the cost of Sonnet 4.5. It's actually two times faster than Sonnet 4, which I believe makes it 100% faster than Sonnet 4.5, because I think Sonnet 4.5 is 50% faster than Sonnet 4. So you get quite a lot more speed with Haiku 4.5. And in terms of the SEW bench, it's actually at a 73%, which is about 11% lower than Sonnet 4.5, just in terms of comparison. So you're actually getting a lot of additional speed and lower costs for quite a good performance. So this is really great. So what are the great strengths of Haiku 4.5 that has just been talked about in the last day or so? Apparently, it's really designed for multi-agent orchestration. So it really does performed better with tasks, and it actually outperformed Sonnet 4 on computer use tasks with 41% score. So it's ideal for real-time customer support bots and chat assistants requiring low latency because of that speed and cost. The trade-offs are it does have less general knowledge than larger models, so it can be better at coding with very specific instructions, but it can't really do many deep reasoning with thought because it might not have that information. So you don't really want to use Haiku 4.5 for, you know, architectural discussions if you're trying to plan with it. Again, it's still very early days, so anything that I'm talking about now could change, but this is just the initial impressions in the last 24 hours, and that might be subjective. So on screen, we've got a comparison of all the different three models. So we're going to start at the top, which is SEW Bench. So we can see they're fairly close, except Sonnet 4.5 is quite far ahead. Then for speed, we're seeing actually Claude Haiku 4.5 actually coming quite close to Grok Code Fast, just in terms of how fast it can respond. But when we get to quality, we can see Grok Code is actually not as high as Haiku 4.5, and then Sonnet is still in the lead. And then consistency, we can actually see Grok Code Fast also again suffering here, where Claude Sonnet 4.5 and Haiku 4.5 are actually quite similar, or actually the exact same in terms of how consistent it is with instructions. And then we get to the cost values and it seems of how good the model is for the cost. And we can see Grok Code Fast actually comes out of top here. And we can see Sonnet 4.5 is at last, with Haiku 4.5 being second. So just a quick look at this, we can see the comparison is Grok dominates on speed and costs, but trails on quality and consistency, where Sonnet 4.5 leaves both in quality metrics and at the premium pricing, and Haiku 4.5 offers the most balanced profile across all dimensions here. That's what we can see from these results. All right, let's just break down what you actually pay for each model so we can kind of put it into its own bubble. The Grok Code Fast, we can see, is 10 times cheaper, which allows you to do quicker and faster experiments with, and then you could probably use a premium model to build the full functionality with that. Then we got Claude Sonnet 4.5. This is the premium model of everything. So it costs a little bit more, but the quality definitely justifies its price. And then we got Haiku 4.5, so it's a bit cheaper than Claude Sonnet 4.5. And it is a bit more consistent, but it doesn't perform as well as Sonnet 4.5. So it's a sweet spot for production deployments requiring quality and scale. So when should you choose each model? So I would say you choose Grok Code Fast if you're on a budget and it's extremely important and you might need that 10 times saving, and speed matters more than perfection for rapid iteration cycles. Then Grok Code Fast might be the best one for you. So when should you choose Sonnet 4.5? When maybe quality can't be compromised and cost isn't really a factor. So you've got complex refactoring or architectural work requiring deep reasoning, long-running optimization tasks, then Claude Sonnet 4.5 will be a better model for you because it's got that safety feature in at the higher price. Then Haiku 4.5, you probably want to choose when you've got cost-sensitive production deployment and you're trying to deploy it at scale and you want consistency, but you don't really care as accurate as Sonnet, and you can afford the decrease of that. It's really good at multi-agent orchestration patterns, even better than Sonnet 4, which is interesting. So you always want to test all of these models before you know, push it to your users, but this is the general buckets you can think of each model. All right, just to run these models side by side, so I'm going to test each one. Anthropic 4.5 on the left, in the middle we got Grok Code Fast, and then on the right we've got Haiku. But essentially what I'm going to make it do is I'm going to make it design a landing page, and at the bottom of the landing page it will also need to use a nano banana image generation, so it'll just like take a prompt and then generate an image. So very simple. So we're just trying to see, one, is it good at styling and following instructions, and two, can it actually make an API call? And we just want to see which one works the best. So I'm going to start with Sonnet 4.5, and then I'm just going to run each one in series and we'll see how it works. So Sonnet 4.5 on the left, Grok Code Fast in the middle, and Haiku on the right. So let's just have a go. And I'm gonna just close this so you can see everything. All right, just off the bat, we can see Grok is streaming through everything. That's already generating. We see Sonnet 4.5 has also created something. And we can see each one is on the build agent just to keep it very consistent between. All right, I had an issue with the first run. It seems like Anthropic 4.5 just decided to make a README instead of actually building the site. So I've decided just to add a sentence to say build the site described in the instructions, and I've just added to all of those and see if it does a bit better with that. So this is the second attempt. I think this is make sure these are gone. All right, and we're going to try again. All right, so I've just cleared that up. We're going to try this again, and hopefully it actually understands what we need to do, especially Sonnet 4.5. All right, we're going to try this again and just see how each one performs. So we're going to stop the haiku, grok code, and then Anthropic. All right, I'm going to let this run and see how it does, and then we will be back to see the final results. All right, we can see haiku 4.5 finished. I started this a bit late, to say about 35 seconds. Grok code was finished earlier, so we just need to put that in. So we're just looking for Anthropic 4.5 to finish and to see when it is done. And we'll look at each website and also maybe just add the Gemini API key. So we'll first just look at how it looks and then we will see each one. All right, so each is done with that in about 50 seconds, so not too bad. All right, this is just a quick look at each website that was made, see if it was formed. So this is the Sonnet one. So we can see very standard generation. We need to put the Gemini API, so we'll see that dog to see if it's got any error. So yeah, so we need to add the API key, so that's great. We'll just check the next one. So this is Grok, and let's just see if there's also a good, and also it gave us a failure, which is great. And if we look at this one, very similar as well. All right, this is put the API key in and just check that it works. All right, so I've put the keys in for each one, so we'll see how it works. All right, so we're gonna try the generation on Haiku. So we'll see if it works there. I'm gonna go to the same one, this is Grok, and we're gonna try the same one. And then we've got our Sonnet, and we're gonna do the same one. We'll see what happens. So this is the image we got from Haiku, so that worked just perfectly. And this is from Grok, same kind of dog, funny enough. And this one was a slightly different one. All right, so we can see each one worked. Very simple website, just to see if it could do instructions. You know, we can improve on this, but it seems like everything worked just as specified. This is just a quick comparison between each one. So we could see if we wanted a cheaper one, Grok Code Fast was great for this. But if we wanted to do more complex stuff, maybe Sonnet 4.5 would be the one to use this. So this was just a quick look at Sonnet 4.5 Haiku model and the Grok Code Fast, just to give a quick feel of each one and just show what the capabilities are. I do want to test these models in a bit more depth in the coming weeks. I'm just traveling at the moment. But if you like content like this, please hit that like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks, guys.